at this hour. Justice Mukul Mudgal has finally submitted his report on spot fixing and illegal betting in the IPL to the Supreme Court just a few moments ago. The report is in a sealed cover, as was expected. Justice Mudgal had earlier sought an extension from the court to complete his inquiry into allegations against 13 cricketers and officials, including N Srinivasan. The Mudgal committee was assisted by IPS officer B.B. Mishra, other investigators and former India captain Saurav Ganguly. Remember, Mukul Mudgal was given the task of getting to the bottom of the fixing mess in Indian cricket last October. But that report has been submitted in a sealed envelope, and the next hearing of the case in the Supreme Court is on the 10th of November. My colleague Arunachalam Vaidyanathan is at the Supreme Court, joins me live from there. So Vaidya, of course, this is a fairly big day because finally that final report has been submitted to the Supreme Court. But really, until the contents are known till the 10th of November, all eyes will be on what exactly is in that report.
Exactly. Mr. Raju Ramachandran, senior advocate and former additional solicitor general representing Mudgal panel, today handed over the report to the judges. And when the judges asked him, is it a final report or interim report, Raju Ramachandran replied saying that the panel got 2 months extension by the Supreme Court. Now it's a complete final report. It's in a sealed cover. And the Supreme Court said it will take up the report on the 10th. On that day, the court will examine what is there in the report, how to proceed further. The Mudgal panel, basically, as you rightly said, the 13 players and officials who are involved, right, they were under the scanner last time.
Vaidya, stay with us just a little bit. We're just going to actually quickly cut across to one of the bites coming in from the Supreme Court of Rahul Mehra.
सातों की सातों सीट दिल्ली में जीते लोक सभा में आपने अभी हरियाणा में पहली बार चार सीट से आप 44 पे आए आपने अपनी सरकार बनाई अपने मत पे अपने बहुमत पे आपकी सरकार जो है महाराष्ट्र में बनने जा रही है जहां आप कभी भी हमेशा तीसरे नंबर पे थे आज आप पहले नंबर पे हैं.
Let's return to Arunachalam Vaidyanathan at the Supreme Court. Vaidya, you were saying.
Yeah, this nobody knows what is there in the report. When the panel submitted a report last time, it was an open report, some two volumes were there. Then they gave a seal cover which has 13 names, which are top players and some officials who are under the scanner. But the allegation against them could not be verified. So at the time, court asked the Mudgal panel report to work with the Mumbai and Chennai police and work on that, whether the allegations against these 13 players and the officials are right or wrong. So today's report basically will be informing the Supreme Court about what is, whether allegations are correct or not. But till the Supreme Court opens the report, probably we won't be able to lay our hands on it.
All right, Vaidya. All right, let's actually quickly return to that soundbite from Rahul Mehra at the Supreme Court.
Investigated, not much comes out of those investigations. Having said that, hope is all an ordinary citizen can have, and I'm hopeful that I'll be proven wrong and Mudgal committee will actually indict N Srinivasan, because indicting Gurunath Meiyappan is only a very small fry that you have indicted. If you really want to go the whole hog, then obviously there has to be evidence which has to be collated and collected, and I don't think there is not enough evidence out there against Srinivasan. The idea is whether that evidence will ever be unearthed and brought before the public. I'm just hoping as an ordinary citizen that I am proved wrong, and the Mudgal committee is not a damn squib at the end of the day as far as N Srinivasan is concerned, because Meiyappan is only symptomatic of the problem. The real problem is the king of the conflict of interest, N Srinivasan.
All right, so that's really the focus of the Mudgal report. All eyes really on the fate of N Srinivasan, and that will perhaps become clearer on the 10th of November when that next hearing actually takes place on that case. But I'm joined also by my colleague Rika Roy on the phone line. Rika, of course, everybody is really expecting that report to give some sense of what action may finally be taken, if any at all, against N Srinivasan. So we'll have to wait till the 10th of November to find out the final contents of that report.
Well, Kashish, what my understanding is that Mukul Mudgal is not going to recommend any action per se. Mukul Mudgal will get to the bottom of the inquiry to establish the missing links, to establish people who were involved, and thereby he is going to tell Supreme Court, he's going to pinpoint those characters and tell Supreme Court what is to be done. But beyond that, all the action has to be taken according to IPL rules, IPL rules and regulations. So that's what he is going to say. Whether Chennai Super Kings or Rajasthan Royals are going to be scrapped or not, we have to really go ahead and see. Right now, we can only get to know about the fate of the two franchises, as well as Mr. N Srinivasan, once the hearing takes place on 10th of November. And I don't think that this matter will be resolved in one hearing. It will take a few hearings to come to the get to the bottom of the IPL mess and thereby get a solution.
Just for the sake of our viewers, just to quickly recap what we know so far of the Mudgal report in the last many hearings.
The Mudgal Commission was given the task of getting to the bottom of the IPL fixing and betting scandal on 7th of October last year. And after speaking to about 1,000 witnesses, he had submitted his report on the 10th of February in a sealed cover, and in which he had specifically spoken about 13 officials and players of BCCI who needed to be probed further. Thereafter, the panel was given extension for another few months. When that report was submitted, and in fact, during that extension, the Mudgal panel was also given the help of an IPS officer, B.B. Mishra, and greater powers to search and seize. Because earlier, Mudgal panel did not have the powers of searching and seizing documents. Now, this Mudgal panel, which was reformatted in the month of May, had those powers. So since then, they have been talking to various people with the help of Delhi, Mumbai and Chennai police. In September, they again sought a two-month extension to complete the final report. And today, the final report has been submitted. What we do understand is that the voice samples of Gurunath Meiyappan and Bindu Dara Singh were tested by the forensic laboratory. And they have, in fact, been vetted by the forensic laboratory. Right. And thereby, that betting link has now been established in this report.
All right, Rika. So, of course, really the big focus now will be the 10th of November when the contents of that final report will be known.